pleased to say hello to you and to welcome our families and students back to school. I know that the staff of Medisnap Public School Division are really excited to see students back in our buildings again. Not gonna lie, there's a real mixture of emotions because for those of us who've been doing this for a long time and for those who are maybe brand new to teaching or working in schools, we're all kind of in the very same place right now because everything is new to us right now. It all feels new and that brings a mixture of excitement and perhaps a level of concern as well because we really, really want to make sure that we get it right for your children and for one another and for you and the community that we serve. And so here we go. Monday, students start coming back to school. This is, as I said, a new way of being, and that new way of being requires us to attend to some things in a way that we haven't in the past. And so, as you know, in our plans that are posted to our website, in scenario one, there's a masking expectation for students grades 4 to 12 and for all staff in our schools. And teachers will be working to teach their students how to do that and also working to support them in practicing doing it well, taking them off properly, putting them on properly, and all of those things that go along with it. Extra attention to hand hygiene and respiratory hygiene, and there'll be movement patterns in hallways, and all of those things will be new. What won't be new, though, is that everyone who chose to work in schools, people who wanted to be teachers and educational assistants, to work in school offices, even to work to clean schools, they come there, or at least they stay there, because they care about kids and because they want them to feel safe and cared for, and they want to learn with them and help them to learn. And so really, this is a good thing that we're back together and we're happy to have you coming back. There have been some pretty big things going on over the summer, and I want to speak briefly about those. Transportation, those who rely on transportation to get their children to school, our big yellow buses, we'll see that there's been some really significant changes made. Historically, we've been really informal with transportation. We've had people get on buses and come off buses. They didn't have to register for them. If there was room at a stop, you could ride. But that is really not something that's sustainable, and it certainly isn't something that can happen in the COVID era. We've been directed to reduce the capacity of our buses. We've been directed to load from the back to the front of the bus, to set seating plans, to take attendance, to do all of these things in order to mitigate the spread of the virus, but also to make sure that contact tracing is something that's more easily done by Alberta Health Services if we have an outbreak of COVID-19. And so we've had to begin bus registration, something that we've not done before, and we've had to come a lot closer into alignment with what Alberta Education provides as the walk limit, which is 2.4 kilometers for all students. Now, our board has had a long-standing practice of providing transportation for students up until grade 3 at a 1.2 kilometer walk limit, and we're certainly still committed to doing that. But all of this change has produced some dislocations. There's some challenges around registration and folks who are concerned that they've always had transportation and they still want it and so on. And so right now, our transportation coordinator, Robert, is working through a lot of appeals, folks who believe they still should be transported, and building routes and adding students to those routes and working with Southland to try and reach a rider goal of about 44 students per bus. That work continues. It's continued late into the evening every day, and it's going to continue through the weekend. And as fast as we're able, after having added staff to support Robert, as fast as we're able, we'll try and lock it down for those folks who initially found that they were not eligible for transportation. So I know it's challenging, but we ask that you're patient with us. Chromebooks. We started moving Chromebooks out to schools this week for pickup by families. We began with the priority of at-home learners and high school learners because our high schools move to a quarter system, and so things move fairly quickly. In the last 2 days, we've moved 400 Chromebooks out to schools for pickup, and they're hard at work in getting them out to folks here in the next little while. Everyone who has ordered a Chromebook, a new Chromebook, we certainly will be able to provide, And if the 1 in 2 year devices run out, we'll be able to provide you options for purchase and loan. Remember, nobody will go without, so if you're not able to purchase for financial reasons, then we'll have loaners for your children and we'll make it work. The theme, I think, for this year is patience and grace. Because, as I said earlier, everybody is doing something in a brand new way. Every student, no matter what grade they're in, is going to be living as a student in a way that they've never done it before. And in fact, none of us have ever done before. Every teacher who's teaching is going to be doing it in many ways in a way that they've never done it before. The way we relate to one another has shifted some. The ease with which we're able to engage with school has changed some. What we are trying to do as a system is to make sure that while those changes, some of them are inevitable, they're things that we can't really mess with because of COVID. What we can ensure that we do is that we're patient with one another and that we offer one another grace, because there's a lot about this that is challenging and a lot about it that's hard. While we're all really excited to get back to school, I know that the great people that I work with in Medicine Public School Division come to it with a real sense of responsibility, and that brings a level of stress that's challenging. And I have all the time in the world for the great people who are working in our system to do great things for your children. And so we're going to have some hiccups. We've had a few over the summer. We tried to get at things as early as we could, and into the fall, while we're learning to do these things, we may have a few more. We ask that you talk to us, tell us what you're feeling, tell us what you're experiencing, and then give us the grace that we need to make changes and make it better for you and your kids. You know that on our website, under the COVID-19 tab, we also have scenarios 2 and 3. Those scenarios are what might happen if the spread of the virus picks up in our region or across the province. It's a good idea to just know where they are, and we'll certainly give you a heads up if we think it's time to start to read those to be aware of what's going on. The hub serves as a way for us to make sure that we serve ELP through grade 9 students who are uneasy about attending during scenarios 1 or 2. If we shift to scenario 3, every teacher in the system really becomes a teacher of the hub, and their students just remain with their teacher and we carry on. So no need to try and plan what you're going to do in scenario 3. We've got you covered. We'll take care of that. So thank you. Thank you for all of the kindness and care that you've shown our schools since March. Thank you for the kindness and care you give to your children and to our community, and for the kindness and care and the patience and grace you offer the staff of Medicine Public School Division. We appreciate you, and we really look forward to seeing your kids.